This week, we enter the mind of some deranged and brutal criminals. These are the instruments with which they destroy people's lives. And this is their victim. This week, on America's Really Wanted, Ralph's Barber, and Dentist, and Dermatologist.
Tonight, exclusive new video inside the Hollywood home of singer and film star Martha Raye. Then, You Asked Us For It. An aspiring singer gets her dream audition, and a married woman gets to meet her dream girl and try a lesbian experience. And Stuttering John meets the gay protesters at the St. Patrick's Day Parade.
I'm taking that theme over.
Johnny's retiring.
Johnny is gone, and Howard stole his theme. All right, we're back. All right, we're having a satellite fest tonight, Robin. It's unbelievable. Oh. Yes, we have a big celebrity here on our satellite, Mark Harris. Now, everybody loves Mark Harris because they remember him from Homeless Hollywood Squares.
Yes, he was a big hit on that.
Now, why is Mark Harris a celebrity? I mean, you're looking at him, a handsome guy. You say, did I see him in a movie? No. Did I see him in theater? No.
But he done commercials?
No. Do I look orange to you? Do you see my real skin tone? And do you see what's going on here? Why am I the host of this show and Mark Harris looks better than me?
Are you part Indian?
I don't know, but anyway, this is, of course, the... I'm part Indian. Yes, this part of me, this part isn't. He is the husband of the famous Big Mouth, Martha Raye. Mark Harris, everyone. Martha Raye. You know, Martha Raye had a long, illustrious career. Now, for some of you people out there who don't remember Martha Raye, here's a little snip, a little piece of tape.
To remind us.
Remind us of who Martha Raye is. Hey, wasn't that a good piece of tape? Yeah, I love that. All right. Now, also, hey, Mark, how you doing?
I'm doing fine, and you sound great, Howard.
You're damn right I do. Look at you.
What kind I wish of... I could...
Now, did you steal that jacket from Martha Raye?
No, it's one of my own designs.
I can't believe how beautiful
that is. Design as well.
Now,
you
why
like
aren't you at home with Martha Raye? Because doesn't she need help with her toilet and things? I mean, shouldn't you be there?
She has assistance, you know, for the hours that I'm not there especially.
I see. And the two of you have still not had any sex, is that true?
Well, did you see how I showed off my bedroom, her bedroom, and the bathroom in the middle?
Well, that's why we're here. We haven't seen the tape yet. We're going to watch it with you.
But I wanted to ask, on something very important, Howard.
Yeah.
When Mark is there, does he send all of the assistants away and he totally takes care of Martha?
Yeah, do you take care of Martha alone?
I assist. They assist. Everybody helps out. I mean, it's not a thing where she just needs one person or two. Whatever happens.
And the two of you never had sex together when she was in her walker or anything like that? Anything kinky?
Not even with a nurse. It may surprise you.
That's wild. Well, there he is. He married a 75-year-old woman. A lot of people say that's outrageous.
Yes, it is.
A lot of people think that's bizarre. But who knows? Who's to question it? Me? No, I can't question that. You know,
Howard, she's a 75-year-old American treasure. You are aware of that.
As a matter of fact, years ago, Mark Harris was jilted by Helen Hayes, I think.
Is that right?
That is correct. That's just kidding around. But in all seriousness, have you been attracted to other older women like Jessica Tandy, for example, or any other elderly people?
On a more serious note, I was asked constantly, had I dated women older than myself? No.
No. All right. Well, here we go. This is what happened. Mark approached us and said, look, I've got all of this access to famous people.
Yes.
Now, very few people have even seen Martha Raye since Mark married her.
That's right.
So what Mark has provided us with is what? Martha Raye had a party at her house?
I gave her a St. Pat's party because that's her holiday.
I see.
Unfortunately, I didn't bring the present with me. I got her this little Bichon Frise dog. And we dyed him green for the occasion.
Oh, my.
He's fabulous.
Oh.
It was really fabulous. Lights, he looked even greener.
And how is your lawsuit going with Bette Midler? Because you feel the movie For the Boys was based on Martha Raye's life. Isn't that true?
Well, you know, I had a call the other day from one of Maggie's attorneys. Maggie, that's Martha Raye's real name.
You get to call her Maggie.
Thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, yes, we all call her Maggie.
Is that what you call her in bed?
Lieutenant Colonel Maggie.
Yes, and rather quickly, what is the status of that lawsuit?
We're getting ready to serve Bette Midler. You know, it would only be that much greater if she wins the award for Best Actress. It would just heighten the publicity so much more. But it is documented that she met with Martha Raye in 1986 in her home, left with the script that Martha had written for
her. How much money are you suing for?
Well, I don't have the exact dollar figure because it's not only Bette Midler involved, other people, and of course 20th Century Fox.
Do you consider varicose veins an erogenous zone?
No, not at all.
I see. All right.
But now, you do.
Right. Let's see what happened at the big party. Aren't
you
excited?
Yeah, let's look at the tape.
I'd love to see it myself.
Now, this is shot right in your home. You do not sleep with Martha Raye. You, in fact, sleep in an adjoining room. Is that correct?
That's right. Are you showing off my bedroom?
Yes. We're going to watch it right now. Who did the video? Did you produce this video yourself?
Yes, and you were kind enough to send me a very nice crew.
All right. Oh, here we go. Nice. Mark Harris.
You've asked me so many times about where I sleep. This is it. My bedroom, adjoining bath, I'm going to show you soon. Just to prove it to you, and I sleep alone, no company. This is it, Howard. Nice? Here you go. Adjoining bathroom. Look at it. It leads all the way into Madame's bedroom.
Now, that is the bathroom you share, in fact, with Martha Raye. Is that correct?
Yep, that's it.
That's what you share, a bathroom.
Two different doors. I know when she's there, and she knows when I'm not there.
What kind of marriage is that, though? I mean, marriage. How is that a marriage? A marriage is when a man and a woman sleep together and share most intimate of thoughts, intimate of feelings, intimacies.
Yes, and cheat on one another respectively.
Well,
no,
you,
there's such a thing as devotion and being nice and kind towards one another.
And I'm looking in that bathroom. If you're taking a dump, does Martha have to smell it? Because
no, not at all. We have Lysol for all occasions.
No, but I'm saying there is not a separate toilet area. Is that correct?
Well, it's in the corner, you know. And then we have another bathroom appropriately named Jane Fonda.
But you never walk in on each other when you're on the bowl?
No.
Okay,
no.
Here we go.
In Madame's bedroom, I promise you, circa 1949. Come on, let's go right here.
Up.
Here we are. Closer to Norma Desmond, you're not going to get. Watch the chandelier. It's not from Woolworths. Show you the vault.
The vault? Well, yes. What do you mean, a vault?
Contrary to the Globe tabloids, they're not mine. They're not mine. They're Martha's, including her fatigues. You got it. Everything here. Okay. All these people here, Martha Raye, today on your holiday, St. Pat's Day, this is my wife, Martha Raye.
Now, there she is. There's Martha.
Great.
Now, Martha was happy to have our cameras there, Mark?
She was surprised, and yes, she was very happy.
Yes. Okay, that's good. And she's wearing a beret. Does she paint? I paint, and I wear a beret when I paint.
She's the mom of Special Forces, USA.
Right. Okay. Let's see who else is at the party. I'm fascinated for you to bring us into your life like this.
Isn't that nice?
It's very nice.
Now, you know, I'm very honored to have married America's greatest treasure, Martha Raye, celebrity star of feature films, television, radio, I dare say Broadway, and records, and of course, America's biggest mom, the queen of military, Maggie. Colonel Maggie.
Hey, Maggie.
Now, Mark, are you identifying yourself to her? I mean,
she remembers all too well.
I know. All right, she does remember. All right, here we go.
Of course.
All right.
As you could see around the room, she has a lot of friends. A lot of friends over the years from Hollywood. And we'd like to reminisce to give Maggie the great rewards and accolades and everything we could attribute her to, just to say what she has done for us and this country.
I did three or four shows with Maggie.
Hey, the Joker. Hey, that's the Joker, Mark.
He looks great, huh?
Yeah, Cesar Romero.
I was with him last night. We were having a drink, and we were discussing who is Howard Stern.
Do you ever get jealous of Cesar and Martha's relationship, that he might steal her from you?
Well, he promised me he wouldn't.
All right, let's continue. This is fascinating. This is just a regular night at Martha Ray's, a little party night.
Yeah, we've had many, right. Yeah.
Do you think you're annoying some of the older folks in the room?
Especially Martha.
No, but I dare say waking them up.
I don't want to speak for Martha here, but it did seem like she was somewhat annoyed by you pointing this camera and lights in her face.
Surprised.
Yeah, very surprised. All right, here we go. I can't wait to get back to the action.
It was the greatest show to do. It was such fun to do. We're talking about the television shows that I did with you.
I did with you.
It was such fun, you know. They don't make shows like that anymore.
And the famous Rosemary.
I never worked with Martha because we were both funny. But I used to see Martha in and out of NBC. Remember when we used to be up at the station up there?
We tried to top one.
Now, let me ask you something, Mark.
Yeah.
Rosemary, were you ever attracted to her?
I only met Rosemary the other night for the first time. I've enjoyed her work only, for the record.
I see. And was there any kismet between you two?
Did your eyes meet?
Did your eyes meet, or you only have eyes for Martha?
Only for Martha.
All right. That's very admirable.
We've been friends for a very, very long time. She's the most wonderful woman in the world that I know of.
Ruth Webb.
Oh, it's
the agent that got away. 18 years with Martha Ray.
Mark, let me ask you something. You have any friends your own age? Seriously, well, is it difficult for you to be around the older generation all the time? You're a young man.
Howard, you may find this difficult to believe, but I had some surgery myself. I'm not much younger than they are.
I see.
Well,
all right.
Wait a minute. When he brings his friends over, does Martha just lay down the welcome mat as well?
Yes. In other words, you're...
Absolutely. Welcome mat, food, everything rolls out.
All right. Well, here we go.
happy St. Pat's, Maggie.
Thank you, Ruthie.
We're finished now, Martha. Anything you want to say to the audience out there?
No,
they're loving to see you.
No, I can't say anything to the audience out there.
All choked up.
I think that you should open that, Maggie.
Should she open it on camera?
Yes, she should open it.
I don't know how she puts up with you, Mark. I got to be honest.
Why?
I don't know.
It's stimulating.
She did not look like she wants to be near you in that camera. I'm going to be honest with you.
Oh, no. She was fine.
She had nothing to say to the audience out there.
As a matter of fact, the party went on so late because of Martha, she didn't want it to end, you know?
I'm surprised Maury Amsterdam was not there.
That's a good point, but he wasn't there.
Were you ever attracted to him?
No.
Of course not. I know that.
But he has a beautiful wife.
He does. I understand.
Very beautiful.
All right, let's continue just to see a little bit of the end here.
Yes.
Where'd she go?
Because it's something very much to do with her career.
Oh, is it?
Yes.
Is it money? Money?
With her real career.
Oh, wow.
Oh, this was taken over in Vietnam.
1966 in Vietnam.
This was in Vietnam.
For the boys.
Yeah.
The one who really did it, Ruth. Ruth, the one who really did it for the boys. Tell them.
Yes, that's Maggie's story. Bette Midler stole it.
Mark, you seem like you're badgering everyone, to be honest with you.
You're not in the court yet,
you
Mark.
Let me tell you, Mark. Robin Leach badgering everyone,
I can't
too?
Believe it. All right, let me just see the rest here, because it's a very interesting scene. Now, your life is very interesting to me, I must tell you.
Oh, to you?
We want to eat.
Let's go eat.
Look at that.
That's the dog.
Bichon.
What? Angaba.
Now, who's that? Who's that bald guy? Who was the bald guy with the glasses?
With the power frames.
With the power frames, those powerful glasses.
Oh, yeah,
who's
no,
that?
That's Martin. He's a very old-time photographer in Hollywood and really one of the greatest.
Martin, who got the Martin?
You should have him on your show, Howard.
Now, and there's some pictures on the wall of Martha. I guess that's the study with her and her green beret. Very good. Now, the green beret that she is wearing on your tape, was that from Vietnam as well?
Yes, it is.
That's one of the green berets. Well, there it is. What a life, huh? A guy married to a 75-year-old woman hanging around at a party with a lot of her old friends.
Yeah, and you enjoy that.
I have a wonderful time. I really do.
You could see where people might get suspicious and think you're in it for the money. You understand that, Mark?
Before they knew me, maybe.
Yes, I understand.
Yeah, but not now.
All right. Well, there it is, our reporter on the scene, Mark Harris, who promised me he would go out and shoot some pictures of his relationship and his house and of the friends that he shares with Martha Ray. And you've done an excellent job, my friend.
Thank you, Howard. This may be one of your best shows.
I hate to tell you, Robin passed out on the floor during this. I can't believe
I'm sorry I wasn't there.
I tell you something.
I'm sorry you weren't there, too.
I tell you, that's unbelievable. Well, who will you be working on next? Will you be going to anyone else's house for us?
The only reason why I'm not going to tell you is because it's going to be a shock, such a surprise, major star.
All right. Well,
and
we
you
can't
have
wait.
It, Howard.
Well, whoever, you got to find someone who's got some money.
We can't wait for the next piece of tape.
We're looking forward to that.
Thank you, Howard.
All right. Bye. Thank you, Mark.
Bye,
Mark
Robin.
Harris, everybody.
Bye-bye.
There he is. Martha, Mr. Martha Ray.
Our Hollywood reporter.
I never thought he'd get the camera in the house, but he did it.
He actually knows Martha Ray.
He actually knows her. I didn't even think they knew each other, to be honest with you. I had no idea. I can't believe it. All right. We'll be back. Don't move from your TV set because more excitement is coming. Don't ask me what I'm doing now. Don't even talk about it. It's unbelievable. What is this, a bacon commercial? What is going on here? Well, we got two pigs in here, and let me bring out my beautiful spokesmodel. This is Teresa Lynn. Teresa, come on out. Wow, you're a beautiful woman. Absolutely sensational.
Hi, Howard.
Wow, you look great. Now, are you a big fan of the show?
I love you, Howard.
Oh, thank you very much, and you are very beautiful. Now, these are breast implants?
Yeah.
Aren't you nervous about the breast implants?
I'd better be with them than without them.
Better, you like it better this way. What did you used to be, like an A cup?
No, I was a C cup.
And what are you now?
I just lost a lot of weight and there they went.
Wow, well, you look great. And you know what? I don't think that silicone can hurt you. I don't think so. With those,
good for your social life.
I'll tell you so. I'm sure all the guys go wild for you. Now, what are you going to do with these pigs? Now, I understand that pig's name is Michael and that one's Alexander. It's Alexander Michael. All right, is that right? All right, now, what do? You oil these pigs up, and then you what? You wrestle them?
Well, you have to pin them.
How did you get involved in something like this?
Insanity. Lapse of my mind. It just left for like a day.
I see. Do you want to try that now? I mean, are we going to see? I don't ever saw anything like this. This is the first time I've ever seen. You want to try it? You want me to hold these bottles?
You probably will never want to see this.
Really? You like doing? You do this in clubs?
No. It's a special guest appearance for you. I came out, and I'm doing it again. I did it once, went into retirement, and now I've decided to come back and do it just for you, because I love
you. Does it hurt the pigs at all?
No, but they squeal like crazy.
All right, well, let me see what that is. I'd love to see it. There's the oil over there, and show me how to do that. This is some stupid show, and I'll talk about Snapple. I've never seen anything like this. I understand this. Is this a very popular thing? Very popular. All right. This is Teresa Lynn. Now, what do? You oil the pigs?
Yeah, slightly.
Well, you must you must be a lot of fun.
Oh.
Come on. I never saw anything like this. Yeah, slightly.
You, like I said, you probably won't want to again.
Right. I see. You're oiling the pigs, and what happens now?
What you?
I'll tell you, the lights are so hot in here, they'll probably suntan these pigs. Now, where are they going? They're running away from you, aren't they? I don't think they like you.
I don't think
you
so.
You mind oiling me?
Come on, Alan.
Well, what happened here? What is going on?
They're like hiding.
Well, all right. I tell you what, maybe we'll see that later. I tell you what, we're going to try that on the next commercial. And let me tell you about Snapple. Come over here, will you? Oh, you're a lot of fun. You ever make it with a woman?
Never.
Never?
No.
Two guys at the same time?
I like the male anatomy.
Two guys at the same time?
No, I haven't been that fortunate.
You made love on top of the Eiffel Tower, is that true?
Yes.
Well, do you love the taste of Snapple?
I love Snapple. Snapple is my favorite drink of all time.
Well, you know,
I don't go anywhere without it.
Wow, isn't that great? A woman who oils pigs loves Snapple. Everybody loves it. Now, have you heard some of the big soda companies? They're coming out with clear colas. They're trying to imitate Snapple. You see, Snapple is all natural. They don't understand these other soda companies. This is what people want. Why should you drink preservatives and artificial coloring? Do you know there's no artificial coloring in here? You see this peach, Melba? The only color you're seeing is the natural color of peach. Do you believe that?
I believe it.
Yes. I would have liked to have seen the pigs, but I don't know what happened. This is some show. Anyway, Snapple sodas are made with 100% natural ingredients. Absolutely no chemicals, no artificial colors or preservatives. They're salt-free and caffeine-free. Now, I want you to try Snapple. You will love the taste of this soda, and it's good for you because there's no artificial anything. There's a wide range of flavors, including diet. Get Snapple sodas and other 100% natural products made from the best stuff on earth. It's Snapple. Pigs love Snapple in their trough.
Attention, losers. It's time for You Asked Us For It.
you want to be happy? Do you want your pathetic life to change? Well, here's the man who can make your dreams come true. The Dreamweaver, the shining star himself, Jack Offit. Welcome, Jack.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, great. Thank you, Robin. I tell you, I have a pornographic chin. I'm back there stroking this thing. I love it. I can't believe it. Yeah, that's right, Robin. I'm the guy with the dreams. I love to make your dreams come true. You know, I know we are going to top last week's show, but it's going to be rough.
Refresh my memory, Jack.
Jack. I told you we should have rehearsed this.
Refresh my memory, Jack.
Spoken like a true pro.
What happened in last week's show?
Well, let me tell you something. It was unbelievable. Last week's show was so exciting. First, I helped you get a date with your bald mystery man. Man, look how happy you look.
Oh,
and then,
I remember now.
And we got Stuttering John a role in the porno movie JFKY, the story of a rear-entry president. Last but not least, we really made dreams come true. For our executive producer, John Lolis, we arranged a dangerous liaison with an underage runaway teenage boy.
Wow!
Yes,
now
we
I
did.
Remember! That was really a great show, Jack.
Yes, it was. And you know something? I love making dreams come true. That's why so many of you write us letters.
So what do you have in store for us this week?
We are going to bless someone's life this week. Let's bring out our first dreamer, Robin. Please welcome Lori D. Raffle. How are you? Take a seat.
This is Jack Offit.
Yes, I'm Jack Offit. Come take a seat, my dear. Don't be afraid to have all of your dreams come true. Let me tell you something. My dream this week came true. Ralph made me up so I don't look like Merv Griffin.
Yes!
Let me tell you something. Now, Lori, you wrote me, and I have your letter here. And you told us that you've had a pretty tough life so far. Is that correct?
Oh. Yeah, it's been in and out of tough, yeah.
You poor little doll face.
That's survived it. That's the main thing.
Well, now, how tough has it been?
You said that you had financial problems. Is that correct?
Now I am, yeah.
Things are pretty tough?
Yeah.
Things at home, you've been without work for a while?
Yeah, my husband's been out since the second week of December.
So it has not been easy, and the kids are having a hard time, is that right?
Right.
What's wrong with the kids?
Well, you try not having any money, you'll see what's wrong with your kids. Well, you say that your husband thinks you look like Donna Mills. Let's take a look. Do you look like Donna Mills? Let's see.
Well, that's Donna Mills.
That's Donna Mills, side by side. Do you know what? You look a little like Donna Mills, don't
oh,
you?
Yeah, yes. I see a resemblance.
I see the similarity, yes. Now, you say that your husband tells you that you sing like Stevie Nicks. Is that true?
Mm-hmm.
Does your husband have a tin ear?
Yeah, come on, seriously.
Well, it's not my husband, you know.
Everyone says you sing like Stevie Nicks.
Not everyone, but...
Can you sing a little bit like Stevie Nicks for us?
Yes.
All right, do a little Stevie Nicks type stuff for us. A little something, anything, I don't care.
The landslide song?
Okay.
Acapella?
Acapella, or without music, either one.
I thought we were going to have a little musical accompaniment.
Well, we will in a minute.
Okay.
Go ahead.
I took my love and I took it down. Mm-hmm. I climbed mountains and I turned around. And I saw my reflection.
Very good, yes! Well, you told me that your dream is to sing on television. And you want to get a record deal and split the money with me, Jack Offit.
Oh, my.
That's right. And my dream is to go deaf. I don't want to hear any records. I don't even care. But let me tell you something. I don't want any of your money. Now, you want a record deal very badly. That would get you out of a financial bind. Now, I happen to know, and Robin, you know this as well, there are record producers who watch our show every week. And maybe you can impress them. So I'm going to ask everyone in the audience now to pay special attention, because we're going to have a special song.
We have a nightclub set up here.
Yes. Yes, we do. Look at that.
Look at our beautiful curtain and the ball.
Where did we get a budget for that, Robin? I can't believe it. Well, I can't believe it. Now, the smoke is to give you that sexy kind of look.
Make you look more like Donna Mills.
That's right. Make you look... Enough smoke. Go on over there, Lori. Lori, you asked us for it. Ladies and gentlemen, for your listening and viewing enjoyment, I give you the mother of two who sings like Stevie Nicks, and through the smoke, she even looks more like Stevie Nicks. Now, that's what we have the smoke for.
We're not just friends. We were just lovers in love now. I know it's a truth. And even dreaming of here in my old heart, you shine so bright just like from the start, because you show me the way to keep on dreaming on. And all alone, just there for a moment, I'm sure to lead us to, well, something new. Something new.
Your dream came true on this show. Robin and I got so romantic during that song. It's the first time that ever happened to me. You know, last week, I had Robin on all fours during a romantic song.
Now, wow. Jack, don't tell our secret.
You sounded great. You really did. You know, one of the ways to get ahead in the record industry is to put your hand down Jack's pants. If you don't go
That's
for that kind
I
of thing.
That's how I got ahead.
You don't go for that kind of thing? Well, you sing very well, and I want to say something. Eric Clapton here is a pretty good guitar player. Come on, let's hear it. What's your name?
Scott Appel.
Scott Appel, everybody. Well, hey, what the hell is this ball hitting me in the back for every minute? Woo! Well, let me tell you something. I know there are record guys out there, and you sang very well, and I hope we made your dream come true. It's time for a couple with a wild sexual fantasy. I want you to meet Michelle and Don Martell. Come on out here. Wow, hubba hubba, yeah.
Woo! Welcome, Don and Michelle.
Well, let me say, I love your outfit. This is your wife, huh? She looks hot, I love it. It's with a belly button exposed. I love that look. You guys are wild swingers. Come on, sit down. Hey, let me tell you something. This show is unbelievable because we make people's fantasies come true. Now, you contacted us. Tell us, what is your fantasy?
To meet Becky Reck.
Now, take a look at this picture. This is a picture of Becky Reck. She's been on Lesbian Dating Game a couple of times.
Uh-huh.
Describe your fantasy with Becky. What would you like to have happen?
Just about anything.
You'd like to kiss her?
I'd like her to use her sex toys on me.
You
the
would.
Ones that she said in her room, her harnesses.
Oh, you remember everything she said.
So what's so special about Becky, do you think? Is she kind of masculine looking? Is that it?
Oh, she's cute.
She's cute. Are you bored with your present sex life? Your husband looks like a stud. He looks like
Not at all.
Not at all? Are you a little jealous of this? Maybe you're afraid you'll lose her to lesbianism?
Rather lose her to that than another man, you know?
You'd rather lose her to that than another man. I understand. Now, how did you two meet?
An old boyfriend of mine.
I see. And what do you think
of
Becky?
His best friend.
Are you attracted to Becky at all?
I don't know. I haven't met her, you know. I'd like to meet her.
I see. Well, what will your family and friends think of this?
I really don't care.
You don't care? Will your mom be watching the show?
Oh, definitely. I told her to watch.
Oh, my goodness.
Did you tell her what you were going to be doing?
No, I figured I'd let that be a surprise.
Robin, are you crazy? We can't tell her mother. Her mother will have a heart attack. Well, Michelle, are you nervous?
No, not really.
I am going to ask Becky to come out here right now. You asked us for it. Come on out, Becky.
Becky Reck.
Becky Reck. Here she is. Wow. All right. Well, how do you like that? There you go. Well, let me tell you something. Take a seat.
Now, wow, Becky.
Becky, aren't you amazed all the times that you've been on the show, all the women go wild for you. Isn't that true?
Yeah.
Now, what do you think of this beautiful woman who saw you on TV and wants you? What do you think of her?
Pretty cool.
She's pretty attractive, isn't she?
And what do you think of Becky now that you see her in the flesh?
Same thing I did before I came on the show.
Are you having sexual feelings right now?
Quiver, you mean?
Yeah, are you a little nervous?
Well, yeah, I guess so. A little nervous.
Ooh. I think there are magnets in her tattoos. I really do. They're all attracted. I mean, you know, as sexy and as attractive as I am, Jack Offen, I can't believe I don't even get this much women. Are you attracted to Jack Offen?
Not really.
Hey, come on. This looks a little like Becky, don't it? Yeah.
Hey,
go ahead and touch it. Go ahead. It's like being with a woman. Yeah. Hey, old man, are you having some fun? You might get to see these two in the sack, huh? Well,
what do you think? What do we do now?
Do you feel like kissing each other? Oh. Huh? Do you feel like that?
Yeah, he does.
Do you feel like that? I mean, you're blushing. Come on.
Now, you probably haven't kissed a woman since you were 14. Oh, even your husband wants it.
He don't care. Do you mind if they kiss? Not at all. Are you sure?
Absolutely.
Take charge, Becky.
You
want to kiss her.
Jack, how did that make you feel?
I need another Kleenex. Hey, you two, I have a great idea for you two to really get to know each other. If you really would like to take me up on it. Now, here's my idea. First of all, I think Becky ought to take off that bandana. Yeah. No, but in all seriousness, I need bigger pants. Hey, did you two see the show where Martha Quinn and I did the love scene from Here to Eternity? Did you see that?
Yes.
Did you see that scene?
No.
I did a beach scene with Martha Quinn.
What have you got on your mind?
I'm losing it. I can't tell you how romantic it was. It was an actual scene called From Here to Eternity.
Martha, you remember
Quinn,
that movie?
Martha Quinn and I were on the beach.
No, I remember.
And I played the man. But Becky could play the man. You guys could do the same scene.
You could be Burt Lancaster.
Right. You could be Burt Lancaster, and you could do the Martha Quinn role. And you two would have something to do together. You could act out this scene, the beach scene.
Will I be soaked?
Well, I don't know what'll happen. It could be wild. You want to give it a try? You want to see a little bit of that scene? Do we have that on tape? Do we have a little of that? What do you think, Becky? Come on.
You must be crazy.
Let's have some real cold. There I am. Look.
You don't give anyone anything, do you? I already told you that I've never met anybody who made me feel the way you do, and then you called me a...
Karen, listen to me. I didn't think it was possible. But I love you.
Well, I know.
I love you so much.
I didn't think it was possible.
I love you so friggin' much. Would you two guys like to do that for your fantasy?
My fantasy.
Come on, Becky, you want to try it?
Yeah.
Rolling around on the floor.
Reading from the part and being an actor? Would you like to try it, the two of you? Come on, let's have some fun. What do you say? What do you say? Oh, you want to try it?
She wants to.
Yeah! When we come back, this new couple, while the husband watches, will act out From Here to Eternity on this wild fantasy show. We make your fantasies come true. I love shows like this. I love it. I love it when people volunteer.
I never knew it could be like this. Nobody ever kissed me the way that you do.
Nobody?
No, nobody.
Not even one out of all the women you've been with?
Now that would take some figuring. How many women do you think there have been?
Well, I wouldn't know. Can't you give me a rough estimate? Or maybe I already know.
What's the matter? What are you hinting at?
Why, is there something to be hinting at? Maybe there's been a long line of beach parties like this one.
You must be crazy.
Don't go. Kiss me.
Oh!
Yeah.
Hey, 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 hey. What happened to a really passionate kiss here? Come on.
Come on.
Don't you remember the beach thing with the waves washing?
Hey, don't you guys... What, do you guys want me to put the lines on Becky's tattoos? I mean, what's with you guys? Come on, passion, passion, passion.
Passion, now do that again.
What, just do the kiss again?
Are you two hitting it off? Are you guys liking each other?
Yeah, I like her, fine.
Hey, look at your husband over there. He's holding hands with Gary. Hey, whoa, look at that over there. Now pick it up from there and keep kissing. Passion.
You're in love.
You're in love.
I gotta...
Don't go. Kiss me.
Oh. Yeah, wrap your arms around her. Put your leg around her. That's it.
Yes. Oh, there you go.
That's good, that's it. Now that's a love scene. Now that's
you don't leave a person anything, do you? I've never found a woman that...
Michelle, listen to me. Listen, I didn't think it was possible, but I love you.
I know. Until I met you, I didn't think it could be possible either.
Ouch!
What happened?
This bottle of massage oil stuck me in the ass.
Oh, yeah, that happens on lesbian beaches all the time.
Well, here, let me rub some sand all over you.
Give her a rub down.
Oh,
yeah. Rub her down on her belly.
Feels good. I don't know. Motion lotion.
I think it's Plax.
Hey, let me tell you something, Becky. You act worse than you dress. What kind of massage is that? Look at that. Come on, passion.
Keep going.
Keep moving along.
Oh, Becky, I feel so crazy. This is so romantic. You, me, the ocean.
Oh, my love, I will shelter you.
Hey, it's a fish.
Keep going.
Passion.
Hugger.
Save the fish.
Get the fucking fish out of here.
Yes, sir. Nothing ever felt so right back.
Yes, we're a perfect pair.
Like fork and knife, hand and glove, tuna and fish.
Hey, what about your husband? Hey, what about your husband?
Do you think he's jealous?
Put the fish back in the bucket.
Yeah, they're dying over here. Get the fish.
Come on, what is that? Hey!
Get the fish.
What the hell are you guys doing? The fish is dying.
We can't kill the fish.
Yeah.
Get that one back there, Jack.
Oh. Hey, that was some scene. Isn't that something?
Yeah.
Wow. Kiss again. Wild. Kiss again.
Yes. Take me.
Kiss. Wow. Ooh, I'll tell you that. Well, I got to tell you, that was a great scene. I can't believe it. Let's bring out your husband now.
Yeah.
Well, how do you two feel about each other now that you...
We got wet together.
How do you two feel about each other? Look at the hair under your arms. You got more than me. I can't believe. Now, how did you two like that? Come on, turn around to the camera here.
It was great.
Now, did that turn you on, seeing your wife? You did?
It was great?
You're not a little jealous?
No.
Can't believe it, huh? And what about you? Did you feel very romantic?
Oh, yeah.
And you got turned on during those love scenes?
Yeah.
What about you? You liked it, huh?
Oh, yeah, especially with the water.
You like that?
Flying in my face.
Do you two think you'll see each other and go out on a date?
Possibly.
Do you think so?
But he's buying.
Yeah? And you don't mind?
So we got plans on.
Okay. Yeah, you plan on...
We have a babysitter.
You have a babysitter and you plan on getting together. Well, dreams really do come true, I tell you that. And I want you guys to come see us again after the day. Come on in, Robin. Let's say goodnight to everybody.
Wow, Jack, I can't believe this worked out so well.
Yeah, that's what's great about it. I can't believe how great this show worked out. Well, we're going to let you two go off alone and get to know each other better. Remember, if you ask us for it, we just might give it to you, okay? Goodbye, everybody.
Bye.
Yes, I am a lesbian.
Well, you can't tell me that. That you're Irish.
Wow. Huh? Is this some show or what? packed with excitement. I can't believe it. And look at our stuttering John.
The finale of a great show.
Hero of the stupid.
Look at that new hairdo he's got. You notice? It's very subtle, but there's a sweep to the side like Veronica Lake. Right?
You like that?
Yeah, I love it. I love it. It looks good. It looks
you
very
really
nice.
You think that's better?
I think so.
I think it's a little better.
Maybe we ought to change that insignia to Hero of the Unkempt. Well, come on, let's get right into it. Where were you this week, John?
Well, I went to the St. Patrick's Day parade. The gays weren't allowed in the parade, so they all had a little, protest. A
little protest?
Yeah, because the Hibernians wouldn't let them in.
Hibernians? And who are the Hibernians?
Beats the hell out of me, but
all
let's just
right,
get right
let's
into
find
the
find out who it is.
Anti-gay.
All right. Here we go. Well, there's the big parade, everybody. As you can see, there's a lot of marching and a lot of wacky outfits.
How do you know your kids are straight?
There's no Howard Stern?
Unfortunately. Yeah.
You don't like him?
Sexist bastard, please.
Oh, really? You don't like him?
Not at all.
Because he's having a show this Friday if anybody wants to come on.
Not.
What are you protesting about?
Our exclusion from being in the parade.
So you're a lesbian?
Now, she has a very deep voice, doesn't she?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
wait till you find out what she did.
Basically, post-operative transsexual.
Oh, so you're a guy?
No, I'm not. I was.
Oh, really? And you had it chopped off?
Yes.
Oh! Well, was that painful or what?
No.
Hey, now, wait a second. Wasn't she at the Martha Ray Mark Harris party?
She
looks a little familiar. I gotta check that out. I'm gonna look into that. I'll tell you that.
It was not, but I was asleep at the time, you know.
So now you're happy about it?
Oh, of course, yeah.
Whoa! But isn't that like a scar down there? I'm like...
Not since I last looked.
Are you a lesbian?
Yes, I am.
Oh, really?
Yes, I am a lesbian.
But you can't tell me that you're Irish.
No, I'm not Irish.
So, you know, what does it matter, you know?
Bigotry is wrong.
Give her a nice kiss.
Whoa! My goodness, now those are two girls, aren't they?
Yeah.
Interracial lesbian love.
That, you know, I've always said interracial heterosexual love is the most taboo kind of love. But to see this taboo kind of love, to see a girl kissing a girl of different races is...
Ooh. It is really taboo.
Oh, my goodness. Let's see it again. I got Erin Goboner. Woo. Salt and pepper lesbos. Hey, hamma. I wonder if their parents are watching tonight.
He's fat.
Is she familiar with Howard?
I'm sorry?
Familiar with Howard?
I don't like Howard Stern.
I'm sorry.
How come?
I think he's a homophobe. I think he's very sexist. And I just don't like him.
This is a girlfriend.
He's sexist. He's not a homophobe.
I might be sexist, but I'm no homophobe.
You see, did you... You know that's a girl.
You sure you wouldn't want to come on the show?
No, thanks.
I saw how he treated lesbians on his show.
Well, he had you make out and stuff. You don't like that?
No, I think that's disgusting.
Is your boyfriend here?
Yeah, here's Josh. Josh is a great fan of Howard Stern.
Oh, yeah, yes.
So you guys are like boyfriends?
Yes.
And you don't, you're like exclusively going out?
Over here.
So you're a lesbian?
Yes, I am.
No, I didn't know that. How would I know?
We're all
is there a way to tell
lesbian here.
Is there a way to tell if someone's like lesbian? Is there something to look for?
No.
No, I'm being honest.
No.
You wouldn't want to come on the show?
No.
Seems like a lot of lesbians wear hats.
Maybe that's how you tell.
That's how you tell.
There might be something to that. I was wearing a hat the other day, some women started coming on to me.
I just personally don't like the man. Period.
He isn't against gays or anything.
Then he ought to say that more often in his show.
But get the camera out of his face.
Hey. Excuse me?
Homophobia's got to go, hey, hey.
Ho, ho. Move down the line.
Homophobia's got to go, hey, hey. Ho, ho.
Move down the line.
Now, let me say something. That is a unusual looking... Now, is that a lesbian or a homosexual?
That's our producer, Kevin.
Oh, I thought that was a lesbian. I said, boy, she's attractive. Oh, that's our producer, Kevin. That's right. Yes. He looks good. He's wearing a hat, I noticed. That's our little look at the homosexual community, Robin and John. That was a lot of fun tonight, wasn't it? Wasn't that great?
Yeah.
Hey, come on over. Here's one of the lesbians now. Come on in, honey. Look at her. Hey, she's gorgeous. Come here, honey.
Kevin loved
her. Wow, look at you.
Kevin loved it.
Look at that.
Why don't you like Howard?
I'm maligned, though, because actually I was just holding that up.
Now, you say your name is Kevin McWoman? Now, what happened there? You got to the parade and you got caught up in the spirit of it?
I just got caught up in the whole spirit of it and decided
started
to convert.
Protesting.
Yeah.
Wow, isn't that something?
I had to hold the guy's sign so he could give me his card so we could try to book
a date.
Hey, she's our favorite producer, isn't she? All right, very good.
Next week on The Helen Stern Show, Hermes Murdoch, author of Teaching Your Vagina to Sing, Women Who Marry Farm Animals, and Sewing Up Your Buttocks to Simulate Pregnancy. Saturday at 11 on Channel 9.
All right, everyone, we got to get out of here. We'll see you next week. Good night, everyone.
Set your alarm for 11:30 and start the day with the NBA when Ron Harper leads the Los Angeles Clippers into battle against the Milwaukee Bucks live right here on LA's very independent station, Channel 13.
Provided by Siemens of Paramus.